directions at this point. We need some sandbags.
As it goes for the fun, no, just these.
I've been lucky enough that I've played a few characters that reintroducing themselves to new generations of people. So I see these 10-year-olds come up to me, and they know me as Ace and all these characters they're seeing for the first time. And then there's a 4-year-old that comes up and says, you know, I grew up with you. So last night I was in a restaurant, and a guy came up all bashful, and he said, I'm in a room full of lawyers next door. I came in here, I was going to try to convince you that I just happened upon you, but I heard you were in the hotel. But I could tell in his manner that I wasn't really speaking to the grown-up who had become a lawyer and was dealing with all this stuff. I was speaking to the child that saw me when they were 10 years old.
Fans were happy, we're happy.
He was a kid, and it was wonderful.
I played it
a little bit. We started out together,
the
you know, in the 90s.
Like
so, you know, there's been a rivalry going on for a long time. That was a hard word to say.
The idea is
to get kids away from the video games into the movie theater where they can watch a movie about a video game. Well, you know, you got to have the basis of the character. You know, the lightning doesn't come from the clouds, it comes from the ground. So you have to know who your guy is.
And in this case, it's perfect, to be honest, it was the right thing to do.
I think total genius and complete self-loathing.
I love the character the way he is. In the video games, who he is now in the film, I think it's amazing.
Robotnik is the future. He's not only going to control you from the outside with his machines and his super awareness and your Alexa, but he's going to get inside your body eventually. Nanotechnology, small machines, move around inside you and become necessary.
Denti!
Denti! Denti!